Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about traumatic renal injury imaging. Trauma to parenchyma and or collecting system of the kidney is called traumatic renal injury. Most common signs and symptoms, flank pain, tenderness, hematuria, ischemosis. Hematuria may be absent even in high-grade injury. Demographic age, highest incident around 57% from 15 to 18 years of age. Sex, male more than female. Imaging protocol, contrast intensity in late cortical or early nephrographic phase. View in multiple plan, a transfer. Laceration may be occur on axial imaging. Obtain the lay image to detect ureteral injury or collecting system injury. If parenchymal laceration or very nephric fluid is present on initial image, 5 to 15 minutes after initial image in stable patient. Imaging. In imaging finding, renal parenchyma contusion and laceration, subcapsular or perinephric perirenal hematoma, collecting system ureteral pelvic junction laceration, with the attenuation of 0 to 4 G field and clot. Unclotted blood and or urine. Intermediate attenuation 40 to 80 per ounce unit, clotted blood or urine. High attenuation of 150 to 200 ounce on the lay image only urine contrast leak. Complete UPJ evasion and opacify ipsilateral urethra distal to injury on delay images. Active hemorrhage, high attenuation, isodem to vessel, and no non-anatomic collection on initial image, accumulation on delay image. Vascular thrombosis or evasion, delay or persistent renal parenchyma enhancement versus subtotal or global non-enhancement, plus minor preservation of scene enhancing rim due to capsular art resupply. This is coronal contrast intensity in a 17 years old with an American football injury, so a grade 3 laceration that ended to the renal pelvis with a subcapsular hematoma. No urinary extravasation was seen on delay image. Delay coronal contrast intensity from a follow-up study in a 14-year-old after a skiing accident, so a high grade for laceration with a urinary contrast extravasation from the lower pore collecting system. The perinephric urinoma had increased in size in the initial study. A ureteral stent was required. This is the ultrasound in a 10 years old girl with a right flank pain after falling on to a cell, so a large perinephric hematoma surrounding the kidney. Subsequent contrast enhanced CT demonstrate a fractured kidney and a large urinoma. Only a small amount of blood was found on the initial urine analysis. Axial contrast enhanced CT, so globally, decreased left renal enhancement with several bad shape, PUSI of absent parenchyma, parenchymal enhancement was as well as perinephric bloods and or urine. Delay axial contrast enhanced CT in the same patient, so extravasation of contrast opacified urine into the perinephric space, consistent with laceration of the left renal collecting system. Treatment. Non-operative management is generally recommended in hemodynamical stable patients with grade 1 to 4 injury. UPJ or proximal ureteral evasion warrant from intervention endoscopic or operative. Ureteral stain plus minus percutaneous urinoma drain and or percutaneous nephrectomy for complication of increased urinoma, increased pain, ileus, fistula, or infection. Renal artery thrombosis, thrombolysis stem, angioembolization in hemodynamic stable patient to control ongoing delay bleeding if readily available. Surgery in hemodynamic unstable patient or those failing non-operative management. Thank you.